silence is ever speaking. It is the perennial flow of language. So it's not very clear to me that, you know, how is silence a perennial flow of language?
What is language?
Language is a medium of communication.
Communication. What is the use of communication?
To convey ideas or concepts to from one person to another.
A deeper use? Why do you want to convey anything to anybody?
To make them understand something.
And what if they understand something? What will happen?
Settle it.
What will happen?
They may be able to do something which they were not able to do.
What does that mean to you?
They will become more useful in some form.
So, yeah. How does that help you? What does it mean to you?
It means that, you know, they will become more in line with my thoughts.
And what does that mean to you? Where do you want to have them aligned with your thoughts?
Sometimes it is because we want someone to understand us.
That you have said. So we don't want to run around in circles. You have said you want them to understand you. Why do you want anybody to understand you?
Because we want, there is something within us that it may be a collection of emotions or feelings, you know, which is seeking a outlet.
All right. What if that fellow doesn't understand you?
Then we will not feel very right about it.
How will you feel?
We'll feel misunderstood. I'll feel misunderstood.
So that will keep you?
In tension or anxiety.
So you communicate so as to?
To release that inner tension or inner anxiety.
So you communicate for peace.
Yeah.
Language is communication. Communication is for
peace.
Now, what is Maharishi saying there?
Maharishi is saying silence is the ever speaking. It is the perennial flow of language.
Silence is language, and we just said language is communication. Communication is
peace.
So all that he is saying is that silence is
peace.
Clear? That which cannot be expressed through words is expressed in silence. And that which cannot be expressed in words is immensely important. You require a special language because that deserves a special language. That special language is silence. Hence, silence is the most eloquent expression. That day I was saying that if you want to say something, then use words. But if you want to say everything, then remain silent. Words can only communicate this much, a small portion. They can never take the totality of your being. You are too large and words are too small. Have you not seen this happen? That in moments, when the ego is sublimated, overpowered, dissolved in tears, you find yourself tongue-tied. You can't speak. Have you not had experiences like this?
To do with what we studied yesterday about Chantku saying that useful and uselessness, because in a way we see silence as useless. So this is something to do with what yesterday Chantku was saying, that give more priority to use things which we usually call as useless.
You can relate it there.
This silence is not only just not talking, because I can be silent and yet my mind can totally be running around.
Mostly it happens that way. When you are not talking to others, you are busy talking to yourself.
That's why I am not talking.
Huh?
That's why I am not talking. Because I want to think.
In fact, usually when you are not talking to others, the purpose itself is to talk to yourself. Don't you say, give me a minute, let me collect my thoughts, let me make up my mind. What are all these?
Self-conversations.
It's an internal dialogue. Let's call it a multi-log. Mind is a chatterbox.
Sir, again, there was a sentence that spiritual activity is will asserted and reasserted. I couldn't understand this sentence.
When a saint talks of will, he is not referring to ego's desires. He is referring to free will. Free will is not yours. So spiritual activity is grace shining upon you. That's all that is meant. Spiritual activity is the will of the beyond. Otherwise you can't move into spiritual activity. You can move into a lot of other activities. Eating, sleeping, all these things you can do out of your own desire, but you cannot go to the scriptures or to a guru out of your own will. For that, divine grace is needed.
Mm-hmm.